Alright. So, admittedly, it's been a while since I played Endless Legend for anything other than just enjoyment. The game is very fun. So, I spent my credits already. We're hopping right into it. Come on. What's going on? As soon as I start trying to record this, it's going to go ahead and freeze on me. Alright. Let's go ahead and take this one step at a time. Ah, damn it, I missed. Alright, we're gonna go left and continue counterclockwise until we make our way around the map. Okay, we found a blue chest. We're not gonna open it just yet. Depending on how many keys we have by the end of this, we will go ahead and do so. But my preference would be to head into the secret, the opulent chamber, if we can. Okay, it looks like there's another chest over here, possibly. Damn. Well, one arrow ain't gonna change much. They both live? Damn. Thought at least one of them take damage from that. Oh, you... Oh, come on. I walked right into him. Alright, there's actually one more to the left. Let's head over there first. Stop missing. Come on. My aim's really off in this room. Okay, there we go. Now we get back that and some armor, which is really nice because that is something worth keeping. If we can get one more, we will probably be able to take care of the boss room without taking any damage. Well, obviously we'll take damage, it's just that we canceled out by the armor. Alright, and this one here. One more. Looks like there's gonna be a chest in here. Brown chests. Yeah, the brown chests are not particularly worthwhile. Sometimes they're just consumables, and those aren't really all that handy. Oh, this is hell for ammo. I might come back for that later on. And now we don't need it at all, because we just found it, more ammo. Right, there's a shop to the north, and where is the fireplace? We have not seen it so far. We're gonna go ahead and head to the shop first. If they have some keys, they have only one key available. Meaning that we have to save up for the one key. If there are multiple key drops in the boss room, that'd be pretty nice. This is actually pretty close. Usually the water barrels are pretty far away. So we can just go ahead and bring it right over. This should be right up there. So you walk up to it, press E, and that push starts it moving. in a desired direction, which is not working right now. It's like one pot right there. Just kept it from going. There we go. Should be able to walk right up to it, meaning right here, and then push it straight in. Alright, we found the area, and we're gonna head north from here. We should be able to find what we're looking for, i.e., more keys. Or a boss. Alright, let's address this one last room before we head it. Taking damage now will be really bad. Just gonna play it safe. Okay, we're gonna head right into the boss room. I'm really hoping for at least one more key, because we can purchase a key from the merchant. Okay, that was bad. Oh, come on! So close. I don't even know why I did that. And of course, no keys. We get the anvil, which is it's a very nice weapon. It's not exactly what I wanted, but it'll work. Okay. And of course, we need the key. We have 35 left. There's really nothing else around worthwhile. We can grab the blessing, which I think just gives us a curse. For more ammo. The ammo elemental. It's not really worth it. I don't think so. I'll go ahead and do it. 60. Shadow grows darker. Deal with devil. There was actually no real reason to do it. I just did it mostly because I felt like it. I'm a little curious if there is a more noticeable effect, but I guess not. The little shadow that appeared above our heads indicates that we are currently cursed, and that will stack, proccing a possibility of seeing stronger enemies. Yeah, this is going to be relatively easy if we run into situations like this more often. Just need to angle the shots better. Damn, I missed him. I first wanted to hit the grenades, but I was attempting to hit him and the grenades. And we'll need a key just to get in there, which means we might not be able to get in at all. Great, more chests, but no keys. That was a mimic. We can go back and get some possibly nice loot off the body of that mimic over there. Okay. Heals. Damn it. Antibody heal up. Yeah, it's not all that great. Let's see what the exact effect is. Improve the healing received. Yeah. Pretty much if we do get healing, there's a chance of better healing, meaning more health or something, but it's not all that worthwhile. Preferably, we just not take the damage to begin with, but you know. Life happens. Damn, you just hold still. There we go. And of course there's more. And now we're out of ammo. We really have no other guns. We're gonna likely take some damage here. To be honest, I'm a little surprised we took no damage from that. Considering we ran out of our best weapon at the time. And of course we found the boss room immediately after. But no, we have one key. So we can head to the shop, possibly grab something that will help us. Alright. Marceline over here. The horn, not that great. Shotgun of Love. Shotgun of Love actually is a pretty decent weapon. So we'll go ahead and grab that. We are additionally cursed yet again. Let's take care of the boss fight first. Some additional ammo wouldn't be a bad thing right now. There's no way for us to charm the boss, but this gun deals a nice chunk of damage. As far as I'm aware, there's no benefit for taking no damage during this fight. Alright, he should be done before his next jump. What do we have here? Is this new? big shoddy gun. Shooty gun. Char to clear a room. Gungeon Classic, one of the first to be imported through the Gungeon Acquisitions Department. The big shoddy gun. Power Blast will be short work of nearly... of any nearly... nearly an gun dead? Work of nearly and... nearly and gun dead. Any gun dead? I think this is a typo right there. Okay. It must be charged and it should directly clear a room. So it actually is clearing rooms, which is really nice actually. Come now. Okay, new gun. Alright then. So we lost armor and then subsequently regained armor, which is the weird mix. The plague pistol can be good. The blunderbuss, not all that nice. Nothing else for us to grab here, so we're gonna head out. So there's an item I got last time, which is actually really handy. Something, it's called a metronome. And basically, as long as we don't change guns or take damage, the gun that we are using would deal more damage every single time. Like, 1 point of damage per unit killed. So, it actually could be really handy to have. Mainly, it's gonna require a gun with lots of ammo, though. Okay, let's consider that one an experiment, because we're still trying to figure out the number of necessary shots to take out an enemy. Damn you. Okay, that one is really annoying. And that should be done. Oh, come on. Alright then. Thank you. Queen Skipper? Yeah, okay. Because the mana, because the other one that could have been is the Gamma Ray gun, which is not particularly good. But the Moon Skipper is actually pretty damn nice. Okay. We have a Cluster Mine, which can be useful. Keep forgetting about this thing. It's really nice, and it can do that.
Scan has been completed.
That was interesting timing. Okay, well, let's go ahead and hop right into the boss room with this gun and see what we get. Okay, I'll admit that I was kind of cheating, but also I kind of stuck in there, and then just decided, wait, why aren't I just shooting him when I have the opportunity? I'm actually a little surprised I lived. For the most part, I generally thought that my character would have died. The shots should have been able to take me out, but because they curve, they hit the sidewalls. Gun literally clears entire rooms on its own. Alright, admittedly not very useful. So we actually do have enough money, we can afford to go ahead and buy the Prime Primer. So go ahead and grab that. We are going to worry about possibly finding a way to cross chasms. Whether we get a grappling hook or wax wings, which I found to be rather useful. I never knew what they did until I found them by accident. It allows flight, which allows us to go over chasms, gaps, and whatnot. And for the sake of grabbing the gunpowder and the shell, you can just float right across. Okay, the anvil is still like the go-to gun for being the most powerful thing around. Though I forgot I had it. And oh, that I killed it already. Okay, we're at the room clearer, and we'll stick with the anvil for the time being. We need another key before we head over to the west over there. You gotta be kidding me. Oh, come on. That was so cheap. Like, it should have made it across. Like, why wouldn't it jump? Hide behind the table if you want. This thing will cut right through it. Okay, one chest with... Oh, it's a mimic. One anvil, up and ready to go. And instead we go here. Okay. And E. We head over here. I'm looking at... Ah, come on. There we go. And we head this way. So down here. What we're doing is dodge rolling. From one cart to the next. So you can do it from here, but I suggest over here because it's a much shorter path. Just in case you mess up. Gunpowder obtained. Okay, I'm just gonna do this real quick. So, leave that dude right there. Switch you out, and leave. And this will take us all the way back to the beginning. Dodge out. Okay. Technically, I could have just jumped from the beginning back over here. I should have done, but oh well. It didn't set off the mine. Okay. Exploded with love. That's the best thing about weapons that charm in mass, because you just don't have to worry about stuff like that. Most of the time they will clear out the room for themselves. And I can't do English today. So for the most part, the charm gun is great because it takes out enemies for you. Especially when you can charm an enemy that attacks in mass, like the totem creature we fought earlier. Okay. Pea shooter, no. That thing, no. There's nothing really here worth getting, damn it. Sit over here for now. There is some health over there, we're not gonna bother. One health is not gonna make or break a run. Actually pretty nice here. This thing does not have a lot of spare bullets. And shot. Can make the jump. We can make the jump. Alright, let's see. One. Two. Shot too early. I think that's just a key. I mean, a chest. Yeah, it's just a chest. That's not even anything worthwhile because we don't have a key to get in there. So we swing back over here. It's gonna blow up before we get back. Alright, now we have to head over there. So we head east and we head south, and that should be the boss room. Clearly can't kill the boss with this particular gun. We can get one good shot off. We can do this. And just in case, we're gonna not even remotely risk it. Mind Master. Okay, what do we have that needs ammo? The Moonscaper? Alright. Well, we killed him. It doesn't look like we got anything. We didn't get a perfect. We're actually pretty close. I guess we took damage in the last bit. Policeman's badge. It belongs to the officer on duty at Gungeon's precinct. It seems to be well worn. Whoever owns this badge, probably close to retirement. What? By the book. Okay, like, what does it actually mean? What does it do? Ah, come on. Maybe it says it here. Come on, where's the badge? Badge. Alright. So the one worn, passive, no. It, like, I guess it does something, but we don't know. Oh! Okay. Yeah, he just follows us around. That's fine. Alright, come on. Actually, we can head back over here to the shop, grab a key, and head north. So yeah, I've had a similar bus before. Before it was a turtle, this is a police officer. Okay. Okay. Well, unfortunately, we don't have the money, so we can't do much anything here. Much with it. So, let's head out. But yeah, the police officer is pretty nice. One extra unit shooting guns, which is always going to be handy. Hopefully he's a good shot. One anvil. Where are you? Oh. Oh! You little... That was fast. Where's the last one? Oh, one is in the corner. Done. Lost armor already. Like, we just got in the first room, too. Damn, I just realized we still have no way of flying or crossing a chasm. Which is not gonna be good for us when we try to grab the gunpowder. Not the gunpowder, the ghostly shell or something. I will take it, that's actually a really good gun. That was rather easy. I don't know. I didn't think that would work out that way, but I guess the gun has knockback and then continues to deal damage. So we have to cross, and we have no way of doing so yet. So we're looking for wax wings, grappling hooks. I'm sure there's other methods of getting across, but those are the ones that I know of currently. It's equally possible there's a simple backdoor method that would just cost us a blank or something. I'll give it a shot, see what happens. Yeah, not particularly worthwhile. Guns like that aren't all that useful here. It's a lot of DPS, but not like enough, a lot of shots, but not a lot of damage. And that's the finisher. Still nothing so far. And what? Okay, so we walked into a room, the door was not locked because it was a challenge room, or like a platform room, rather than a room with enemies. Alright. And this room's a dead end, which means it was almost entirely pointless. Okay, we have a decent amount of money, but no, nothing to buy that would give us anything valuable right now. Alright, come on. Time to find something useful, right? We need a key for that. Can afford a key, so let's swing by the shop and see if he has one. Hey, there are no shops. There might be one to the left of here. There's typically a shop on every floor. Every floor I've seen, anyway. Skull Splitter. No key! Damn it. Okay. The Proton Pack's actually pretty good too. Mostly because we can never miss with it. This is a homing gun. But there's no key. Just a neat flight ability. We're hoping the key will give us access to the rail over here. Because we still need to make a way across over there. Alright, I'm split between the Skull Splitter and the Proton Pack. I think for what we're about to go face, we need what we need. Well, I think the Vertebrae would be more than enough. So armor and blanks would be the way to go after that. So let's load up on blanks. Now, if we have enough for armor, we'll grab one too. No, we don't. So, if I remember correctly, we are fighting the wall. No, we're not fighting the wall. We're fighting this guy. What is he called? First Order High Priest. Okay, so I've already taken a hit. Moonscraper. Come on, Moonscraper. Come on. Come on. Oh, no. Come on, come on, come on. Just a little bit more. Oh, that was sweet. Okay. Is he? Kid, listen up. Today might not have been my last day in the forest. I have only been down here because of you. But this ain't your fault. Yeah, you let me get hit by all those bullets. Sure, you probably could have given me one of those fancy guns you've been hoarding, but the point is, this ain't your fault. Give my badge to my kids. Tell them I love them. A vengeance off the rails. Damn. Okay. Like, damn. Dude, like, are you kidding? You saw all those crazy bullets. There wasn't really much my character could have done there. Okay, mahogany rifle and all that, great. These things, not all that fancy. There are 40 credits left. Not enough for a key. There were no keys. I'm gonna swing by over here, and I'm gonna... We don't have any blanks left, so we can't even test the theory that maybe we backdoor it. Alright, well... We've done what we could, and we don't have enough for what we wanted. Alright. But damn, that was like... I'm sure he's gonna show up at the entrance or something like that. Oh, okay. Alright. Okay, I didn't fall in, my corgi fell in. Anything else? No, he's still alive. Oh, what do we have here? That's new. Oh, that's equally new. What happened there? Okay. So we have some new enemies we have to worry about. That is an environmental thing and not a straight-up attack. Oh, that's a freaking trapdoor. Not really a trapdoor, mind you. It's just trap. No keys, we'll come back for that later. Alright, mainly this is working out better than I expected. This is the farthest I've gotten so far. Nice. Okay, the anvil in particular is helping out quite a bit. Damn it. I need to not waste ammo. Okay. Hello? It's been a very long time since anyone has ever come down here. Come to kill your pass? You've made it further than most, that's certain. If you thought it was going to be that easy, I got bad news for you. What do you mean? The gun that killed the past, like everything else, needs ammunition. Otherwise, well, what stopped time here? That's old magic. If you find the gun, you may fire, but how far back will you go? You might just find yourself right back here again. You want to get out of this place and change something about your past, right? To tear a hole that far back, you'll need a special bullet. I can make it for you if, but the materials might be proven hard to find. Tell me what you need. To make the bullet, I need prime primer, lost in the upper chasms, some arcane gunpowder, mined in the heart of the Gungeon, a shard of planar lead broken off from the great bullet when it struck, and obsidian shell casing borrowed from the tooth of the great beast. Bring all of that to me over many lifetimes, and I will aid you in your quest. Okay, I can do it, but I, of course, need more. Also, will this kill me? It doesn't kill me. Okay. It just looks really cool, though. Can I take her shoes? Like, they look like my shoes. Alright. But yeah, the armor is not necessary. The science cannon looks interesting. Ghost bullet, the shock round. The shock round's not really gonna work synergize with the anvil, mind you. Okay, no, we don't want to go in there. Big, scary-looking room. No, not yet. Oh, it's even worse. It's the freaking Reaper, but he's buffed up. Oh, okay. Well, we cleared the room fast enough the Reaper didn't get too many chances to hurt us. Let's get rid of you first. All right. Okay, the biggest issue comes along and that I'm out of ammo for my really nice gun. Also, damn it. Alright, let's see what's in the next room and hope that it dies in one shot. Or not. Okay, let's toss in what we really don't need. We don't need the sticky. What else is not very good? The machine pistol. Come on, give me something good. Now is the best time to give me something really nice. Come on. The Colt 45. The gun has a special gun. Yeah, this is a Winchester. Why did it unlock the Colt 45? Give me a Winchester. Alright then. The Pontini rifle might be okay. What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing, man? What are you doing? Oh, there's nothing here. Okay, the Winchester, crossbow, the anvil, the shotgun, the... Okay, this... Unfortunately, this is our best shot right now. Get like one shot, and then we switch to Winchester. Alright, we found one singular key. That will definitely be of use, though I don't know by how much. that was great. Okay, we have the anvil back. Let's keeping the BSG for now. Okay, so we have ammo for both our breast guns. To avoid taking damage, we're gonna go ahead and switch over. And I think we're good. Okay, we have one singular key. That key, what can we open with one key? This is a breast shot. I don't see anything else on the map that would give us anything useful. Okay. We found. Okay, well, we shoot. That actually could be really useful. Okay. There's the shine cannon. There's the shock round. Actually, the shock round might work here because of the. Okay. No, the shock round is too expensive. The ghost bullet. And then there's the science cannon. I think we have to trust in ourselves. We'll grab the armor, and we're gonna head our way out. Moonscraper is the way to go right now. Hey, we're about to see the big bad. And there might be more after this, but right now this is the biggest thing I've seen so far. What are you? The High Dragon. Dragon. He's made of ammo. And he wields actual guns. Unlike other things we fought so far, he wields actual guns. Like, I'm just not used to aiming at this frame of scale, so it makes it hard to keep track of things. I don't fully understand what we were supposed to meant. Like, there was just so much on the map. And the changing the way that our camera view was really makes it harder to shoot. Okay, yeah, we definitely need better guns by the outcome of this. Because that was just like a mess of, like, stuff. Let's see. We'd have nothing that did explosives and the actual bullet to make the necessary thing. We have to kill the dragon first, obviously. And then once we kill the dragon, we head back to her and she makes the bullet. I don't even know if we even get the gun as of yet. Like, I'm hoping there's more to the game after this, but so far I'm enjoying it. It's great. I've played 84 times so far, as you can clearly see right here. All right. That's it.